qualified for the postseason, and your Boston Bruins would not have.
Yeah, I was going to say, tell it to Peter Laviolette. On the power play, David Krejci going into the corner. But, oh, there goes a pane of glass on a gigantic Lucic hit. Mike Van Ryn on the receiving end of that, and that'll make every highlight reel for about a decade.
Second huge hit in this hockey game tonight, delivered by the Boston Bruins. Period number one, it was Dennis Wiedemann on Matt Stajan, and now Milan Lucic on Mike Van Ryn. Van Ryn trying to handle that puck along the boards, and you can see him, Jack. He's bracing for the hit. He knows it's coming. He moves the puck. He knows he has to pay a price to get this puck out of his own zone. He braces for the hit, but sometimes it doesn't matter. And you need to stay within the rules. And Lucic elbows down, stick up in the air a little bit, but there was no contact with his stick with Van Ryn. If you like body contact, we've seen two of the best to this point in the hockey game with Wiedemann and Lucic.
He's just in his second season and already a cult hero in Boston. Milan Lucic leads the Bruins with 19 hits this season and the most broken glass so far.
You know, one of the things that coaches used to say to us as players, Jack, was even though you're on the power play, you can still play physical. You can still hit. You know, the Bruins are on the power play right now. 30 seconds left in Shen's penalty. Bruins start the second period on the power play. Go ahead, be physical. Knock people off pucks. And that's exactly what Lucic was doing.
Some of that falling glass struck a fan, and I think she might have a small cut on the top of her head. And it doesn't look to be a serious situation at all. But it's amazing how this glass is constructed, that it does not shatter in sharp, spiky shards. It comes apart in pebbles. There are still sharp edges. I'm not minimizing that, but it falls apart in pebbles because of the way the glass is manufactured.
Can you say that three times fast?
No. I could barely say it once.
Sharp, spiky shards.
Right. There it is. Kerblam.
Almost seemed like Van Ryn, when you watched that several times, it was more of a reaction, as if some of that glass might have got down under his jersey, correct?
His sweater, yeah.
Yeah, that seemed to be more the reaction to the hit. He absorbed it pretty well. He knew it was coming.
Yep. Well, I got a feeling that that highlight is going to air in every local sportscast in the nation tonight. Folks, it's Lucic. Lucic. Get it right, okay? Cult hero in Boston. Amazing. And you know, here's a guy who's already kind of come out of his mini slump. Milan Lucic had all the hoopla, had a terrific playoff series against Montreal, then kind of hit a flat spot right at the beginning of the season, but he simplified things and he got his game back.
Yeah, and I think it's a job of the leaders of the hockey team as well as the coaching staff to get a kid like Milan Lucic's attention in training camp. You know, and sometimes it takes a decreasement, if that's the right word, a reduction of ice time, a reduction of responsibility, taking off a top line where your expectations are based on what he was able to accomplish last year, and predict or certainly, you know, place him in a position where you think he's going to be most effective this year. And sometimes young players, many times I should say, young players, you know, they need to get refocused when they come back for their second year.
There's the delay, just 20 seconds into the second period. We'll be back to the Garden after this break.